Welcome to this 2DV604 software architecture course, theme 1. This short lecture will introduce you to the ISO 42010 standard for software architecture documentation. The focus in that standard is on stakeholders' concern and views, or viewpoints and views. So the idea with this lecture is to introduce you to the important aspects of documenting software architecture. What we will focus on is to find the answers to who are we documenting for? Who is the receiving end, at the receiving end for our communication? And what should we communicate to them? What are the elements of our architecture? What decisions, the level of detail, etc. So that is the second. And the third question is how. How should we address the expectancies on expectations on the receiving end from the stakeholders? How should we find the middle road where we can provide sufficient detail while keeping the presentation in the documentation on a level where it's easy to comprehend and etc. So we try to do this, and this is actually the essence of software architecture presented in one picture. So what we have here is a number of strategic decisions that the architect or architects make, and well, we fill a bucket with all the decisions, and the challenge is to find the best ways to present these to the stakeholders who are interested or have concerns with respect to the system. And we have to find ways to select the right decisions, of course, but also how to present these decisions in a way that we come up with a tailored presentation for each group of stakeholders. So the focus is on strategic decisions, but then we have this communication problem. And over the years, a state of the practice developed, and this was at some point discussed and merged into a standard document, which is explained in the standard ISO 42010, and they provide this domain model. And you can see that we have the system, we have the system mission, environment, the stakeholders of the system at the top, and then we have the architecture. The system has an architecture, and this means that, and this is an important aspect of this documentation, that it's not just software architecture, it's system architecture. So it can be software, and hardware, it can be software, hardware, and people. So we can combine complex systems that combines software, hardware into our documentation. But the architecture is described by the architecture description. And then we come to the key points here, and that is at the center of this domain model, you find stakeholders. Stakeholders are groups of people or roles, actually, that has some concern. That is, that they are somehow interested in the system. They have a stake in that system. And stakeholder and concerns, if you look into the standard, you will see that stakeholders of a system have concerns with respect to the system of interest considered in relation to its environment. So that is that we have the system, we have the environment, and then a group of stakeholders who are concerned, who have interest in that system. And concerns is a fluffy concept to some extent, because it can be many different things, and it's also concerns that arise throughout the life cycle. So it's not a requirement that you elicit up front at the beginning of your development project, so to speak. It's something that can pop up all the way down during, well, late fixes, or even after the system, the software is deployed during maintenance. So concerns arise throughout the life cycle. And it can be, well, anything from needs to requirements, of course, but it can also be that someone is interested in how have we solved this problem, what design choices have we made, and also what are the nitty-gritty details of our implementation, and what effect has this will they have on the operations of the system. So it can be things that stakeholders are concerned with throughout the life cycle, and it can also be from the very, very top with business considerations all the way down to synchronization details of communicating processes, how we deal with race conditions, etc. So what's important here is to remember that with the stakeholders and their concerns, we can answer the who and the what question. But now what remains is, of course, the how. And for that, the standard introduces the view. And the view is a set of models. You can see that in the lower right-hand side of the domain model, that a view consists of one or more models. In a model can be anything that is a representation of the system or some aspect of a system. So we can have a UML use case, we can have textual, we can have programming source code, programming language model, we can have formal models, we can have economical models, everything that we need to that we use in order to communicate how a concern is dealt with in the architecture for a stakeholder or a group of stakeholders. So any type of model can form views. So this trinity here is at the very heart of the ISO 42.1.0. But more details on views. Well, it's an architectural description. Okay, so architectural descriptions is composed in the same way as we decompose systems, we decompose our description. And we can organize it into one or more views. And each view addresses one or more concerns for the stakeholder. So this means that it's a partial expression on the architecture for a systems architecture. So compare it to a database. You know, in databases, if it's a relational database, you have tables, you have rows, you have columns, and then you can create queries. So in a query, you can join tables, you can select rows, and you can project columns, and you can ask questions. You ask questions to the database, and the answer is a view. It is a set of rows that may come from combined tables, and then you can project so that you get just the attributes, the information you're interested in projecting certain columns. In the same way, you have the architecture view. You have a set of models, many different types of models, models at different abstraction levels. And when you create a view, you pick and choose from these models. You describe the aspects needed to communicate to stakeholders with respect to a certain concern. How you create these views is defined by a viewpoint. And a viewpoint describes which models to create and how to create them. So a viewpoint defines which architectural models are needed in the view, and then you can develop that model using some established method for that particular view model. It's also important that to remember that a model can be part of several views. So for instance, your UML class diagram can be part of several different views. You can also have use case diagrams, etc. So a model can be part of several views. So now we looked into stakeholders, we looked into concern and also views, and to some extent also viewpoints. But just to come back to the concern, because what is a concern is very important to grasp here. And in the standard, they enumerate quite a few concerns. As you see here, this is a long list and it's not a complete list, but it spans the goal, spans the range from business goals and strategies at the very top, functionality, down to information assurances, all the way down to deadlock. So the concern is not something that the architect decides. It's something that the stakeholder decides. So if a stakeholder asks a question, if they want to know how something or what something in the system, well, that is a concern. And as an architect, you have to provide sufficient information to the stakeholders so that they can establish their own understanding of how we address this concern in the architecture. So remember that it's not a fixed list of concerns that you deal with. It's a list which that the stakeholders create, that they have, that they decide, so to speak. In some instances, it might be that the architects also add concerns because not all stakeholders know everything, know what they have to know in order to make the right decisions. So to summarize this part, well, we have the who, and that is the stakeholder or stakeholders. What, that's the concern or concerns. And how is the view, well, or views. And we define viewpoints, and these viewpoints can be considered as blueprints for which models to involve, or which models a view contains, and also how to populate, how to develop these models for that particular view. So different take on the previous slide is, of course, that we have the bucket of strategic decisions, and what information to select and how to present it for a specific concern or concerns for a group of stakeholders, that's defined by the viewpoints. And then each viewpoint may be used to derive many views. And as you see in the picture, we have different viewpoints resulting in different views for different stakeholders. So ISO 42010 have the four concepts: stakeholder, concern, viewpoint, and view. And they combine into the core of the documentation of your software architecture or system architecture. So wrapping this up, remember the who, the what, and the how. Based on that, you can develop viewpoints. Some of these viewpoints you can reuse from one project in another project, but you use them to create views that communicate what the stakeholders have asked for. We will talk much more about views and how to develop viewpoints, how to use viewpoints to create models and describe models, etc. But that's a different theme. So having said that, well, that's now it's time to move on, and this is also the final lecture for the first theme, and now we move on to the second.